This is DiffTheEnder, and today on A Different View, before I get into my post, I want to announce the winner of my contest that I recently ran. So, let's get straight into that. The winner of the $25 RP card from last week's contest is Funny Animation Guy. So, congratulations, Funny Animation Guy. I hope you enjoy the RP and, you know, buy some skins, buy some champions. Now, today's post. Diminishing Returns, fact or false? Basically, what is Diminishing Returns and why? What is this myth that I'm hoping to debunk today? Here is some armor, or magic resist if you'd like. Armor's picture here. Let's say you're buying armor to become tankier. Lots of armor. Even more armor. The myth states that if you get too many resistances, it's less effective. Now, we'll be taking a look at whether how true that really is. So, are there diminishing returns on stacking resistances? Let's see. This is your health bar. It's nice and green, beautifully. Thousands your max HP currently. Now, when you take damage, it's affected. Oh my god. It's affected by a damage multiplier formula. So basically, this is it. Any damage you take is going through this formula. Now, what is this formula? First of all, the damage. So, that yellow value is the damage that the opponent is hitting you for. So, if an opponent has 1,000 attack damage, that's where the formula, that's where that value goes. 1,000 goes into that yellow area. Now, the green damage is how much damage you actually take. So, after that yellow value, after the 1,000 is multiplied by your damage multiplier, the actual damage you take is listed there. Now, let's take a look at a couple of examples. Let's put in 1,000 as our damage. So, let's say an AD carry is critically striking you for 1,000 damage. And let's say you have 0 armor. What happens to your health bar? 100 divided by 100 plus 0 is just 1. So, 1,000 times 1 is 1,000. So, the actual damage you take is 1,000, and your health bar goes from this to this, since you took 1,000 damage. Now, what happens when you get some armor? Let's say you took 100 armor. The green value is damage multiplier. It's 100 divided by 200 is 50%. 1,000 times 50% is 500. 1,000 minus 500 is 500. So that's how much damage you took. How many hits does it take you to kill you? 2 hits. That's important. Remember that. I'll come back to that later. Now, what if you have 200 armor? 100 divided by 300 is 33%. 1,000 times 33% is only 333 damage. So you are left with 666 HP. Same with 300 armor, except now you're left with 750 HP, since the multiplier is only 25%. What about 400 armor? You have 800 HP left after that one hit. Now, this is where the myth is confused. Okay, so if you had 100 armor, the multiplier is 50%. But if you had 200 armor, the multiplier is 33%. And if you had 300 armor, it's 25%. So as you can see, the percentage value decreases at a slower rate. 50 minus 33, it's 17. 33 minus 25, that's just 8. So are the values diminishing? Here, for example, in the health bar, take a look at this. First hit, you're left with 500 health. You'd only take 500 damage. But the next one, you only take 333 damage. Next one, you only take 250 damage. So it's the same thing as a percentage. The amount that your damage reduced is reduced by is decreasing. So are there diminishing returns? No, there aren't. Let me explain why. If you go up here and take a look at the number of hits it takes to kill you. Here it takes 2 hits, because first hit hits you for 500, and a second hit hits you for 500. Here, you get an extra 100 armor, and the number of hits goes up by 1. So the number of hits required to kill you now is 3 hits. 333, 666, 999, and then you're dead. Another 100 armor, and it becomes 4 hits. 250, 500, 750, 1000. That's how much damage you take, that's how many hits it takes you to die. Now it's no mystery to figure out that if you have 400 armor, it takes 5 hits to kill you. So as you can see, with each 100 armor, the effectiveness remains the same. Each 100 armor effectively adds one extra bar of HP to your life. It effectively means you can take one extra hit of that same value. So what is this trick with the... Sorry. What is this trick with the health bar here? So, I mean, why is it only reducing by a smaller bit? Well, it's to do with effective HP. Each point of armor increases your effective HP by 1%. So, the 750 HP you see here is not as valuable as the 750 HP in this picture. Each point of health here is much stronger than each point of health in this picture. And that's the key to understanding the whole thing. Health is misleading because there's a hidden effective HP behind this. The 1000 HP in this picture is a lot weaker than the 1000 HP in this picture. And that's why the damage values and your health bar seem to have diminishing returns, while in fact, there are none. So, in conclusion, are there diminishing returns on stacking resistances? The answer is no. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video, but there's still one more thing I want to do, and that's the next RP contest. What do you have to do for this RP contest? First of all, you have to be a subscriber. Second of all, and this is the most difficult requirement of them all, be very, very attentive for this requirement. You have to be a subscriber, and nothing else. That's it. Be a subscriber, and you'll be in to win some RP. I'll be announcing that in my next video. I hope you guys enjoyed this content. This is DiffTheEnder, signing out. Cheers.